Oh, it's an exchange token? Oh, is this a leveraged coin? You have to be very careful with leverage coins. These things have so many extra fees that are hidden. The cost to open and close a position is 0.1% of the position size. So, there's two fees. 0.1% to open or close a position is 0.1%, and there's an execution fee as well, which has two transactions. The cost of the second transaction is displayed in the confirmation box as the execution fee. So I think there's actually like three fees in, right? So this is why you have to be... The amount of profit and loss you will make will be proportional to your position size. In this example, 352 has been used to buy. If the price of ETH increased by 10%, the position would have a profit of whatever. Okay, if the price of ETH decreased by 10%, the position would have a loss of 175.29. Huh? If a short position was open instead, then if the price of ETH decreased by 10%, position would have a profit of 175. Position. That's not typically how leverage coins work, though. Actually, no, it is. Leverage for a position is displayed as position size. There's also a 3.3% swap fee. So if you think about it, right? These leverage coins... This, it may not be true for this one, right? But leverage coins are, you know, they have to be profitable some way. And these are not necessarily this coin, but these leverage coins in general, like the ones you see on Binance, KuCoin, are generally scams in the way that the fee structure and the leverage structure. So what I mean by this is this. So let's say you have a coin that's like at $100, right? So at 100, okay, and you are in a let's say you're in a short, okay, so you're shorting this thing and it goes down to, let's say, 70. Okay, so you're in the money, right? You're profitable. This is where it gets tricky, though, because let's say, you know, this went down 30%, right? So you went down 30% here. If you go back up, though, that is not equal to going down percentage-wise, because now your short is actually out of $130 here, because you have an extra $30, right? Let's just say hypothetically, whatever your profit is, right? It's $130. So now you're at $130 right here. Your position size is $130. So if this thing goes back up, your leverage is actually this $130. Your position size is actually 130. So if you go back up, let's say you go back up to 90. Okay, you're at 90 now. So you went from 100 to 70 to what, 90. Here, you're probably at break even from $100. Okay, so your money is equal here. From when you shorted down to 70 and then it went back up to 90, you're probably even money now. But if it goes back up to 100, then you're probably at a loss. Isn't that fucked up? On top of that, these leverage coins have what are called rebalancing fees. There's a really good article on this that taught me all this stuff, actually. Let me see if it's this one. Yeah, so there's a rebalancing fee that I was talking about. Yeah, you can't hold them long term because you're paying extra fees. And these things get reset. This is kind of explaining it. Suppose you invest $100 in a crypto, which gains 10% on the first day and loses 10% the next day. In this case, the value of the 3x leverage token is $130 on the first day because you went up 10%, right? So you went from $100 and you went up 10%. So then this 3x leverage coin, you're up $130, right? On the first day because it gained 30%, like I said. However, the next day, the value decreases to $91 because the price was reduced by 30%. 130 minus 30%, $91. So going up 10% is not the same as going down 10%. So the first day it went up 10%, the second day it went down 10%. So you would think you'd still be at $100, right? But you're not. You're actually at 91. So highly, highly, highly don't recommend buying leverage tokens on the exchanges and just doing futures trading. These things are generally a scam. But as for GMX, I'm looking through these and it says here, it gives this example, right? This example is very interesting here. And I'm sorry I'm going so in depth on this, Dennis. I know you just want to look, maybe just look at the chart, but the reason that this is so interesting is because what they do here in the description is I think they just give the first part. They don't tell you about the scam part, right? So yeah, they actually don't tell you about the scam part. They stop right before that. So this part right here, let's go back to our chart and let's look at it. So remember what we said, no problem, Dennis. It's more than my pleasure. This is something that a lot of people don't know. Myself, I didn't know for a while until I really looked into it. So what they show here is, remember we said that, and this Binance article said, I'll put this on the chart too. Oops. There we go. All right, so let's look at this. So what they're saying is the very first part of it. They're not actually going into the scam part. So remember, if we go up by 10%, you have a profit, right? If you're going the right direction. But then if it comes down, that's when you lose your money. So if you go up 10%, it's not the same to going down 10%. So what they smartly do here is they say that, hey, so if you buy this coin that's going to be going up, you know, you're saying it's long. If the price of ETH increases by 10%, the position would have a profit of $175. But then they say if the price of ETH decreases by 10%, the position would have a loss of $175. They don't say if this one goes down. That's so tricky, right? Damn, that's how they get you right there. So they're saying that, remember we said that if coin goes up 10% and then it goes down 10%, I don't know why I did that. These are not equal, right? This is not equal, right? However, what they're saying is that they're saying the first part only. They're saying if you buy this coin, it'll go up 10%, right? But if you bought it and it goes the wrong direction, you're going to go down 10%. So they're giving you two situations of the same thing, 10% right here. They're not giving you the same coin if it goes, the same coin goes down 10% from there. They're saying if the price of ETH increased by 10%, then you'd have a profit, right? But then they're saying if the price of ETH decreases by 10% instead of this, you know, instead of going up here, they're saying this, you know, a different situation. Dude, that's so tricky. Holy shit. That's why the first time I read this, I was kind of confused because I was like, this is not how leverage coins work, right? But they're just very tricky in how they explain this. So what they're doing is giving you an alternative explanation. They're not giving you the whole truth here. On top of all these fees. Damn. So they're giving you, if you went long on a coin and went up 10%, this would be your profit. If it went down 10%, this would be your loss. But they're not saying if it went up 10% and then that same one came back down 10%, they're not giving you that one. Because that's when you lose the money, right? Jeez. Wow. Well, with that in mind, yeah, I'm not a big fan of leverage coins, as you can tell. Save on costs. See, what does this mean? Enter and exit positions with minimal spread and zero price impact. Get the optimal price without incurring additional costs. Ugh. An aggregate of high quality price feeds determine when liquidations occur. Okay, that doesn't mean anything. This keeps the position safe from temporary wicks. What? They're just saying that there's a lot of high quality price feeds. Dude, this is the one, you know, one thing you gotta think about this is that is somebody really like, you know, these developers and all these people that put in all this effort into this website, are they really making these leverage coins out of the goodness of their heart? You know, for people that are, you know, maybe just don't want to trade perpetuals or something? Likely not. You know, this website, this nice service, and all the developers, they're not going to, you know, that's not going to just pay for itself. So they have to be getting something out of this, right? And that's what it is, you know? All these extra fees. Leverage tokens, I'm telling you, are like a scam. So, I would be very careful trading something like this. And this actually sounds like a really good video idea. Yeah, I think I'll make a video on this after the extreme. Oh, so there's some kind of trading contest happening here. If you ever come to crypto and you're asking what is the use, that's not the right question to be asking in crypto. What's the use case of this coin? I'd be very careful about this. I'm gonna make a video on this though. Thanks for bringing that up. That's a good question. So even if it does have a good chart set up, just because of the way the dynamics work in these leverage coins, that they are literally there to like charge you fees and make money. Because, you know, it's not like the coin has some like, you know, fake like use case or purpose, you know, like, you know, like this coin is being made, you know, they're going to make the tires for F1, you know, they're using this cryptocurrency, the blockchain from this coin, to make the tires for F1 cars. You know, even though like that's, you know, that's like what these coins present themselves as. But, like, this one doesn't really have any kind of like really the only use case is for the makers to get money off it and incur fees. Because anyone who's trading it could just trade perpetuals, right? Damn, I guess I got a little heated here, huh? Wow. Dennis, did that all make